Hallelujah. You may be seated. The book of Daniel, something amazing takes place that warrants our attention tonight. Is that an edict went out that nobody ought pray in public. And a gentleman who's anointed by God goes home, pulls back the curtain, and begins to pray in public. What was amazing empowerment is that he prayed unto our God in public. Watch this. But God delivered him in private. Y'all just missed that. We still don't know what happened in that lion's den. Some of you were too showy. It's just a few of us. How many of us need a private breakthrough? That it ain't other people's business. I just need God to do something for me behind closed doors. How graced you are that all these millennials later, another man named Daniel has arisen. God has put his hand on for such a time as this, that everything that you've prayed about in private, God now is going to reverse it and bless you in public. I can't hear anybody. And the common denominator is God had to raise up a man by the name of Daniel. I'm so privileged and excited, honored, humbled to have Prophet Daniel with us on today. He dropped on us like a napalm bomb on Sunday. We're still counting the bodies and the casualties. The environment will never be the same because of what rests on his life. I need you to do me a favor. It's been a trying day. It's been a taxing week already. The choir is going to lead us in a moment of contemplative, reflective music. And after they would have concluded, Prophet Daniel will come. Not because of the man, but because of the gift that rests on him. I want you to stand and overwhelmingly receive him when he comes. And let him know how glad you are God sent him in our direction. He didn't send the Prophet Daniel for anybody on your row but you. Y'all didn't hear what I just said. I said he didn't come for anybody on your row but you. If you know you need that word from God, would you shout like I'm talking to you, like this? This has got to be a night for you. The music ministry is going to lead us in a moment of preparation. While you're doing that, hear me, return all the last minute text messages you need. But I need you to put that phone down so that you can hear what God is saying. If you're not sure, run to the bathroom now so that when God begins to move, there will be no unnecessary movement. But all of us will be focused on what God is doing. Lift your hands to receive the word of God. Our music ministry is preparing the atmosphere.
There's a sweet, sweet spirit in this place. And I know that it's the Spirit of the Lord. There are sweet expressions on each face. And without a doubt. Jesus. What a wonder you are. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. What a wonder you are. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. What a wonder you are. Oh, Jesus. What a wonder you are. Beautiful rose of Sharon. What a wonder you are. What a wonder you are.
Yes,
you're the beautiful rose of Sharon.
What a wonder you are.
Oh, Jesus. Oh, Jesus. What a wonder you are. Lion of the tribe of Judah. What a wonder you are. You are the lion,
lion of the tribe of Judah. What a wonder you are.
You are the lion
of the tribe of Judah.
What a wonder, what a wonder you are. Oh, Jesus. Oh, Jesus.
What a wonder.
What a wonder you are. Jesus, say, Jesus, Jesus,
Jesus. What a wonder you are.
Oh, Jesus, Jesus,
Jesus. What a wonder you are.
Oh, Jesus, oh, Jesus. What a
I say clap your hands to the name of the Lord. If you believe that your hands belong to you, clap your hands to the name of the Lord. How many people can feel revival in the atmosphere? Wow, wow, wow. I feel a great presence of God all over the place. Somebody, you are moving forward. Somebody, something great is happening to you right now. Somebody, God is getting ready to favor you. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Father, we give you praise in Jesus' name. I'm really excited to be here one more time to the wonderful people of the living God. And I'm really excited to be at Empowerment Temple. And I bless God for the life of the angel and the shepherd of this wonderful house by the name of Dr. Jamel Bryan. Somebody, let's clap our hands to the name of the Lord. Wherever you are, let's bless God for his life. Now, church, listen to me. God has given us a great pastor, a great shepherd, a great activist, a great preacher. He has everything together. Sometimes you see the way this particular man of God is so busy. Just last night, he went on the TV in another state, and today he's here. You know, you have a good pastor who knows how to dedicate his time for you. He's called for the whole world, but he's also your pastor. And that's a very great privilege. Most of you are not clapping. You don't know. And God bless you, Dr. Jamal, for having me. God bless you. I deem it as a great privilege for me to stand on this particular pulpit and stage of a great general. Amen. When you fly with generals, you also become general. Hallelujah. And clap your hands to the name of the Lord. God bless you for receiving me, having me one more time. God bless you. And all the ministers and the elders of this ministry, let's clap hands for all the ministers and let's clap hands for all of them. Today, by the grace of God, I will pray for the leaders and the elders as well. Okay, all the ministers, I'll pray for you. God bless you all in Jesus' name. Prophet Fitzroy, God bless you for coming with me. And God bless our pastor, Darius Nixon, for connecting me to Dr. Jamal. Amen. Amen. You too, you came to church, so clap your hands for yourself. Clap your hands for yourself. Amen. Amen. I had some friends from US and also in Ghana who said they live around the area. And they said, Prophet Daniel, we will come and support you. If you're my friend from whether Ghana or you're in the US or the prophetess, where are you? God bless you. God bless you. Well, somebody, let's clap hands for them. God bless you for coming. God bless you. Thank you very much. Amen. Amen. Now, just be seated for 1 minute. The assignment for tonight was that we're supposed to bring what?
Water.
Perfect. Amen. Let's lift up our bottles of water. Not only bottles of water were we supposed to bring. What were you supposed to bring? Perfect. Our age. Listen, everybody was supposed to bring their age offering. And the Lord said to me that your age offering will cancel your age suffering. Listen to me. I'm come to teach you about the mysteries of our age in the next 7 minutes. So I want you to hold your water and everybody get your age offering ready. Your age offering, example, if you are 30 years, your age offering is a seed of $30. If you are 50 years, a seed of $50. If you are 1 year, a seed of $1. If you have a lot of children, you want to do something for them, you can just take a seed of $20 to represent your children. But I want everybody to get a bottle of water and the age offering as well. Everybody just get it ready. I'm about to teach. You will take it. And I feel the power of God all over the place. Amen. Get me my water and also get me my envelope as well so that I put in my age offering. Amen. Because I'm not here to only minister to you. I'm also ministering to myself. Amen. So that I also be a partaker of the blessing. Amen. So if you're not here on Sunday, just get it ready. I feel the power of God all over the place. Now, somebody listen to me. Listen to me. I want you to say after me. Say, there is mystery behind my birth. There is mystery behind my birth. Now, everybody listen to me. Whilst you are preparing our age offerings and holding our water, you didn't just appear on earth. You were first a spirit. But a spirit cannot live on this land. So you are supposed to come in a body. So the original you sitting here is not what I see. The original you is your spirit. And the spirit only lives in this housing we call a body. So anytime somebody wants to torment your body, they are tormenting the wrong entity. Because the original you is your spirit. And the day you were born, somebody hear me, the day you were born has a very great significance in your life. You didn't just come on that day for nothing, but in the mind of God, you were supposed to be born on that particular day. Let me tell you something. When you read the Bible from Genesis up to Revelations, there are different mysteries about birthdays.
The first mystery was that there was a guy by the name of Joseph. And the Bible says there was a cupbearer of Pharaoh and a baker. They met Joseph in a prison, and Joseph said to them the meaning of their dreams. And out of that, Joseph said to one of them, you will be promoted, and the other one, your head will be cut off. But the Bible says in Genesis chapter 40, verse 20, that on the birthday of Pharaoh, that was the day everything happened. On the birthday of Pharaoh was when the cupbearer was promoted, but the baker was killed. So somebody got promoted on somebody's birthday. Oh my God, there is something unique about birthdays. When you go to the book of Matthew chapter 14, the Bible says there was a king by the name of Herod. The Bible says on his birthday, a young girl was dancing. And out of the dancing, he made a promise. And out of the promise, the girl was able to dance. And for the promise to happen, John the Baptist's head had to be cut off on the birthday of Herod. So the cupbearer was promoted on the birthday of Pharaoh. The baker's head was cut off on the birthday. John the Baptist's head was also cut off on somebody's birthday. I want to ask you one question. What is happening to you on somebody's birthday? What is going on in the realms of the spirit? So these things about birthdays, our lives, are really important. When you read the book of Job chapter 1 verse 4, the Bible says every year on the birthday of the children of Job, they celebrate. And it was one of the celebrations that the atrocities happened to the children. When somebody wants to affect you, when they get your birthday, it's enough for them. When they know your date of birth, it's enough. That's why even in the physical world, when they only know your date of birth, the police, the hospital, they can know everything about you. So our assignment for the mystery of our birthday today is to preserve our birthdays in the realm of the spirit, so that when something evil wants to be planned, it will not come against us. Any power of the enemy against your destiny connected to your birthday, we break it by the power of God. Listen to me. The circumstances and the situation that happened around the time you were born is what affects you. Let me tell you again. On the birthday, or when this young man by the name of Moses was born, that was the time other young children were killed. So other children were killed because of somebody's birthday. I want to ask you one question. Who was giving birth around the time you were born? And what are the issues that happen around the time of your birth? On the birthday of Jesus, when Jesus was born, the king by the name of Herod said, go and kill the children. So on the birthday of Moses, children are being killed. On the birthday of Jesus, children are being killed. In the realms of the spirit, birthdays are what are being used to attack an individual. But we are about to put a supernatural insurance on our lives and on our birthdays, so that any plan of the enemy designed against our lives will never succeed. Say after me, say, Lord Jesus, preserve my date of birth. Number three, listen to me. Because of your birthday, the water you carry is this. The water, we will pour it on ourselves. I will give you prophetic instructions. Make sure you listen to all these instructions before you leave the house, okay? Because you also do some in your house. We are pouring the water. Anytime there is a seed, when water comes on it, the seed germinates. So as we use this water direction, we are putting water on the seed of our birthdays, and God will bring long life to our lives. Any spirit of premature death against your life will never succeed. Listen. Whilst you are busy moving about on your assignment, working, somebody is somewhere waiting for the day you will die. Oh, whilst you are here, somebody is waiting for the day they will hear news that you are no more living. But listen to me, I came to serve them and notice they shall wait for a long time. I said they will wait for a long time. You know what I mean? Not only are they waiting for a long time, but they will wait for a long time until they perish. Oh, I said they will wait for a long time until they perish. Slap your neighbor and say, my neighbor, they'll wait for a long time. Say, my neighbor, they will wait for a long time. Now, my last 2 minutes, listen to me. Listen to me. Let me tell you something. One day I was there, then the Lord started dealing with me. Daniel, there are some things people don't choose for themselves. God gave me 9 things that people don't choose for themselves. I can't tell you all, but I'm giving you some. Listen to me. Nobody here, you didn't choose the midwife that came to help your mother to give birth to you. Did you choose your midwife? So if you can't choose your midwife, I want to ask you one question. If you didn't choose the midwife, then the midwife who was there, what was the agenda about their lives about you? If there is an evil midwife that comes around the time you were born, my brother, my sister, you are in a big problem. Because if that midwife carries evil eye or carries witchcraft, they can torment your destiny. If you don't believe me, let's go and ask a guy in the Bible by the name of Mephibosheth. The Bible says Mephibosheth was crippled. He was not born crippled. But when the mother was giving birth to him, the midwife was running away and the midwife dropped him. When the midwife dropped him, he became crippled. I want to ask you one question. Which midwife has dropped you? Which midwife dropped your destiny? Which midwife dropped your elevation? Which midwife? So a guy whose father was a king was now living at Lodebar because of a midwife. Ask your neighbor, who was your midwife? My last woman, listen to me. My assignment for today, everybody listen to me. Follow every instruction. When we put our seed on the altar, I will enter into a place of prophetic ministrations. And God has given me instructions that we will arrange some chairs here. And God told me that people will be given opportunity to come and sit on the chair. And this is the reason. The Lord said, Daniel, when my people come and sit on the chair, I'm taking them back to the womb of their mother. That anything that was taken away from them, they are going to receive it back. Is there anybody here who is ready to sit back on their chair? The chair of your destiny. Let me give the last one, 1 minute. Somebody say, the midwife. Say, the midwife. Now listen. Mephibosheth had a problem by the midwife. Listen, when Moses was going to be born, Pharaoh said to the Hebrew midwives, when the women are pregnant and they're coming for labor, when it's a boy, kill the boy. When it's a girl, leave the girl alone. I want to tell you something. Herod. Who was that? Pharaoh, sorry. Pharaoh, in this context, is the devil, right? Right? But listen, if Pharaoh is the devil, why doesn't he come and kill the children himself? But he uses an agent, that is the devil. Listen, I said, if Pharaoh is the devil, Pharaoh, if you're a devil, go and kill the young boys yourself. But he says, I won't go there myself. I will sit in my palace and I will send the midwives to go and kill them. I want to ask you one question. Which midwife was an agent to take away your life? Be on your feet. I didn't come to preach. Be on your feet. Be on your feet. This revival, I can't preach. Be on your feet. Somebody say, who is the midwife? Say, who is the midwife? My God, listen to me. Issues, many people are now in a lot of issues based on the... Sometimes, listen to me, when I'm talking about the midwife, I'm not only talking about the midwife in the hospital. I'm talking about the first person, the first family member, the first family friend who came around when you were born. When we talk about midwife, I'm also talking about the person who said they loved your mother so much, and because of that, they used to come and help your mother to clean you. Most of the cleaning was not proper cleaning. Oh, I said most of the cleaning, they were not just cleaning you, they were not washing you, but some of them, they were washing your destiny away. God called me at the age of 10 years. I've been prophesying for the past 19, 20 years. And I want to tell you this. In all my prophetic ministrations, most of them, when I trace and I check, I see that many people's issues were connected to when the person that came around. Empowerment Temple, lift up your water and lift up your age offering. Everybody, if you want to use the machine, the swipe card, go there right now. Everybody, if you know you have an age, make sure you do it. If you know you have somebody you love, do some for them. I will arrange the chairs very soon. We will come and sit on it. Is there anybody here who believes that tonight they are going back to the original intent of God? Let's be very quick. Let's be very quick. If you're using a credit card, let's be very quick. We have a lot of stuff to do. Father, I give you praise. Father, I give you praise. The devil is a liar. I said the devil is a liar. God punish the devil. Jesus' name. You can stand here. Jesus. Lift it up. Everybody, your age. Everybody, your age. Everybody, your age. Most of you can do more. Come to pray for a lot of people. Let's be very quick. If you are using a credit card, write your check, whatever. Everybody and your bottle of water. Everybody. Do you know what I see right now? An angel came to stand by this man. Who do you know that is called Kisa? Kisa. Your name is called Kisa. Come. An angel came to stand and the Lord said to me that when you were born at the age of 3 months, somebody came to contaminate your stars. Because I saw the man standing there and I saw Kisa standing by the man. Your name is called Kisa. Come. My God. Get me the oil. Get me the oil. Jesus. Jesus. Sister, let me tell you something. You have a very, very great destiny. But because when I was talking about the midwives, the Lord said to me that an incident happened at the age of 3 months. And the plan at that time was for you to be blind. That's why when you were growing up, in your teenage years, always you used to have a lot of pains on your eyes. And the Lord said to me, the attack was to sabotage you, not to see. But the hand of God was over your life. And the Lord preserved your destiny. Anybody out of jealousy and hatred for your guardians and your parents that they wanted to torment you, they have messed up with the wrong person. I said, tonight, listen, for you to be here, they made a great mistake. I said, for you to be here, they made a great mistake. As I'm talking right now, the Lord also spoke to me that as you pray for another man, that is called Christopher Brown. Christopher Brown. Who is called Christopher Brown? Where is he? Come. Come. Your name is called Christopher Brown. Come. There was a car crash that was designed against you. It was, listen, this state is called Maryland, right? Is there any place in Maryland that is called Tacoma Park? Is there any place like that? Do you know Tacoma Park? That's where you grew up. That's where you grew up. Come. The devil is in a big trouble tonight. I said the devil is in big trouble. Listen, what I was seeing, the attack was not only coming from America, but it was coming out of Africa as well. I've digged down to your roots and your background. I'm come to read your history. Are we ready? Are we ready? Let's be very quick. Everybody lift up your age offering. We came to defeat the devil tonight. Oh, I said, is there anybody here? Listen to me. Where do you go to church? Where do you go to church? You go to another church, but you're also from Empowerment Temple. So you're connected here. But you pastor somewhere. Listen to me. I saw a rope, like a line, that was on your hand, and it was connected to Pastor Jamel. The Lord says, never cut off your connection from this man of God. The Lord says, your connection to this man of God is what is keeping you. The Lord says, some people have spoken to you to cut off your connection. And the Lord says, the day you cut off your connection, they will get you on the car crash. Because I saw that an attack, anytime an attack is coming, this man comes to protect you. So the enemy knows that the only way they can get you is for you to cut yourself off. My brother, be very careful. Be very, very careful. The Lord said, don't listen to anybody. If you listen to anybody, they will get you for the car crash. As I'm talking now, the enemy has tried you 3 times for car crash. And all of them, you escaped. Am I saying the truth? Clap your hands to the name of God. Oh, sorry. Okay. Can I prophesy? Jesus. Somebody say, Jesus. Wow. Auntie, I'm come to pray for you. Somebody hold behind this woman. Stand behind her. Right now. Let the fire deliver you. Jesus, bring this woman for me. Now, everybody. Let me also calculate all my age and put it inside. Everybody. Everybody, are you ready? Now put the age on your right hand and the water in your left hand. Everybody. We have not started. Listen. Go and do your own, and I'll come back to you for second page and page 3. Let the Lord arise. Jesus. Where's my water? Get it for me. Put your seed on the right and your water in the left. My God. Empowerment Temple, you are a blessed church. God bless you. Sister, what do you do? What do you do? Sister, I don't understand American language. Accent. What did you say?
I'm a law clerk.
What was that?
A law clerk.
What?
She works at the law office.
Law office. Yes, I saw her sitting on a chair, and somebody wants her to lose her position.
Jesus.
Come. There's a contention about what she does, and the Lord says we should secure it for you. And a day is coming, if she doesn't know, let her get ready. A day is coming that this lady is going to set up her own big company, her own business. As I'm talking to you now, the Lord said to me that it's something you've been thinking about. And it's something that is on your heart. The Lord says you are going to set up a big firm. The Lord says high profile cases, you are going to be connected to it. But you will not lose whatever that belongs to you. Lift up your eight seed. Now everybody say after me. Say, Lord Jesus.
Lord Jesus.
Oh, say it like me. Say, Lord Jesus.
Lord Jesus.
By my age offering, I cancel every age suffering. Say, by my age offering, I cancel every age suffering. In Jesus' name. Say, oh God. Any satanic midwife, any evil midwife that came around me around the time of my birth, by the power of God, I destroyed your plans. Now, everybody, let's get the offering bowl. Let's come and put it inside. Everybody, let's come and put it down. Everybody, go and put it down there. Everybody, let's be very quick. Everybody, let's put it down. Everybody, Jesus, I will need about 25 chairs. I will need about 25 chairs, but not now. I will tell you to get it. 25 chairs, Jesus. This is a night of power. Someone say power.
Power.
Oh, the way you are saying power, I see you don't believe in power.
Say power.
Sister, you are a blessed woman. You are a blessed woman. Do you come to church here?
Yes.
Secure your seat very well.
Yes.
Secure your seat very well.
Yes.
Just put your offering there and let me tell you what the Lord is saying. Everybody, let's be very quick. Everybody, let's be very quick. Masanta Kabran Tolimi Katalabaya. Let's be very quick. Somebody said there is mystery behind my birth. Say, any evil midwife that came around me
around the time I was born,
may you catch fire. You're about to wait now. Jesus, Let's be very quick. Let's be very quick. We are about to shout fire. Now, everybody, hold your water. Hold your water. We are about to perform some directions. Towards the end of the service, I will give another direction. But I also give you some direction you do at home. So don't forget it. Lift it up. Now, everybody hear me? There is something about water. Can we take it off the stage? Can we take all the envelope from the stage? Can I also take it off the stage, please? Can you take, I want the place to be cleared. Take it off the stage. Yeah, clear them. Okay, clear them. Very quick, clear them. Listen to me. Somebody say there is power in water.
There is power in water.
Say it like you mean that there is power. Say it like you mean it. Say there is power in water.
There is power in water.
Let me tell you why. The first time God was supposed to perform a miracle, the first thing God said was, let there be light. Yeah. And I want to ask you one question. Where was it? It was by the water. And the Spirit of God moved over the face of the water. And God said, let there be light. If there was no water, he couldn't have spoken. Yeah. The first time Jesus was supposed to perform miracle was changing water into wine. It was by water. For God to endorse Jesus, to declare that you are my beloved son, it was by the river Jordan. Water. Mystery about the water. Whenever there is water, miracles begin. I said, whenever there is water, listen, I was doing this kind of direction. I had a service in Sierra Leone, and I told the people, bring water. I prayed on it. I said, when you go home, go and pour it in your house. One woman was going, I said to her, when you go, don't only pour it in your house, by your next door house, go and pour it in front there. I said to her, your next door neighbor is a wizard. And the man turns into a cat and come and cry behind your door every night. And the assignment is to use your blood for an occultic program. I said, just go and pour it over there. The next day, a black cat was dead in front. I said to the woman, it's not a black cat that is dead. It is a human being. After 3 days, the man died. The occultic man, he died. And I said to the woman, that is why you are living now. Because you are the one going to die. And God reversed it. Lift up this water. Say, by the blood of Jesus. Auntie, just go and stand there. I will come to you. Tonight, I want to prophesy. I have more time. Don't worry. And get the 25 chairs ready for me. I'll call for it later, okay? 25 chairs. Lift it up. Say, by the blood of Jesus.
By the blood of Jesus.
Listen, say it like there is power in the blood of Jesus. Say, there is, by the blood of Jesus.
By the blood of Jesus.
Say, oh God.
Oh God.
Let this water.
Let this water.
Become the blood of Jesus.
Becomes the blood of
let
Jesus.
This water.
Let this water.
Become the water of miracle.
Becomes the water of miracle.
Right now.
Right now.
As I use this water.
As I use this
let
water.
Let there be a miracle.
Let there be a miracle.
In my life.
In my life.
In my family.
In my family.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of
say,
Jesus.
Say, oh God.
Oh God.
Arise.
Arise.
Open the water. Open it. Now follow me on the control. Follow me. Put your right hand on your belly. Say right now.
Right now.
Say right now.
Right now.
Any hidden disease in my body.
Every evil disease in my body.
I flush you out.
I flush you out.
Now.
Now.
Out.
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 Wow.
Now.
Out.
Out.
Now.
Now.
Out.
Out.
Now.
Now.
Now say after me. Say right now.
Right now.
Any food I have eaten in my dreams.
Any food that I've eaten in my dreams.
Any food I have eaten in my sleep.
Any food that I've eaten in my sleep.
That was contaminated.
That was contaminated.
Come out.
Come out.
Come out.
Come out.
Come out.
Come out.
Now.
Now.
Say right now.
Right now.
Any disease.
Any disease.
In my blood.
In my blood.
Come out.
Come out.
For the second time. We are in a revival, a night of miracles. Now follow me on the control. Place your hand here. Say right now.
Right now.
Say right now.
Right now.
Any satanic contamination.
Any satanic contamination.
In my destiny.
In my destiny.
Come out.
Come out.
Now listen, Listen, the human body is made of 70% water and other stuff is 30%. So you standing here, water is really important. Now put your hand there. I speak right now. Listen, somebody's vomiting. Miracles will happen. Get ready for her. Get her tissue. Because miracles are happening. She's vomiting. Bring her to me. Where are the ushers? Where are the ushers? Bring her to me. Things are coming out. Where are the ushers? Where are the ushers? Everybody shout fire.
Fire.
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 Oh, who is helping me? Oh, where are the ushers? Give her the tissue. Because this lady, Dr. Jamal, this lady was given a food to eat when she was at the age of 11 years. And the food they gave to her to eat, it was rice and stew. But the meat on it was not proper meat. The meat was a human finger. And the Lord says it has brought a deposit of witchcraft against her life. So when she drank the water, the water became the blood of Jesus to break. Oh, oh, sound the scream. Now, right now, right now. Go. Fire, fire, shout fire, shout fire,
fire,
shout fire, fire,
fire,
fire,
fire,
fire,
fire,
shout fire,
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 fire.
Oh,
fire.
Oh,
fire, 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 fire.
My God, my God, Jesus, my God. Get a 25 chest ready. Get it ready here. Get it ready here. Bring it, bring it, bring it, bring it. Let three women help her, you understand? You know, when I'm ministering, anything can happen. So get other two people to help you. Okay, get two other people who are strong to help you. Jesus. Get 25 chests, line up here. My God. Someone shall fire.
Fire.
It was human finger that went into her. That's why she vomited it out. Who brought her to the church? Who brought her? You brought her. You came together. She's your aunt, your friend. Your mom, God has delivered your mom today. I said, God has delivered your mom today. That's why everything your mom does, she's always in trouble. Nothing is moving for your mom. Nothing is moving for her, right?
Yes, sir.
Nothing is moving for your mom. Because the Lord said to me that that's what they did to your mother, to destroy her life. If it is not God, your mom was going to die on the 14th of September this year. Come. Where does she come from? Sierra Leone. That's what they were planning. Bring it. Because I saw it in Africa. That's why I asked you where. Everybody shout fire.
Fire.
Shout fire.
Fire.
Shout fire.
Fire.
Judas spirit. By the count of three, leave her alone. One, two, three. Go. 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 Break. It's okay. Somebody scream.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Shh. Shh. Now, for the last time for the water, after what I do right now, you keep the water down. We will do it later on toward the end of the service. If you leave, you have missed the direction. Can you hear me?
Yeah.
Don't leave before pastor closes us, okay? Yeah. Give me my water. Where is my water? Jesus, sister, your mother is safe. Your mother, listen, listen. That's why of late, your mother, all the time, she's been saying negative things, like she's going to die. I'm not happy. That's what she's been saying,
yes.
That she's going to die.
Yes.
Because your mother's funeral casket was already designed. I've seen the funeral casket. They have designed everything for her death. For her death. They've designed it. I see that she'll be there. She stand up one day and she just collapse. They will say heart attack and that will be it. The Lord says, Daniel, it's not heart attack. The Lord says, it's not heart attack. The Lord says, it's not heart attack. It's a spiritual job. But thanks be to God for Empowerment Temple. And thanks be to God for Recovery Crusade. Now follow me on the control for the last one. Then I'll give you the next instruction. Jesus. My God. Are they 25? Yeah. Come and hold it for me, please. Follow me on the control. Everybody follow me on the control. Okay. Follow me. Sorry, Bishop, for messing up with your carpet. Sorry, Bishop. Sorry. Everybody follow me on the control. Follow me. Follow me. Follow me on the control. Follow me. It's a spiritual matter. Forget about your makeup and do the thing. Listen, everybody listen to me. When you wake up in the morning, before you even have to brush your teeth, you have to clean up your face. Why? You do that because it's a new day. By this direction, you entered into a new phase and a new day of your destiny. Listen, now, anything, just leave her. Auntie, woman, minister, leave her, leave her. The angels are working. Leave it. Leave it. Listen, by what you just did, there are some people in life, any place they go to, people don't like them. When they don't like you, it means there is something in your face. Any evil spell that was put in your face for people not to like you, I just took it off in the name of Jesus. We take it away in the name of Jesus. Shout away.
Away!
Number three, listen. By what we just did, a star is about to come on your forehead. When your star is shining, wise men locate you. Because when the stars of Jesus were shining, that's why they brought Jesus Christ gold by the wise men. By this direction, I declare as a prophet, may your stars shine. May your stars shine. May your stars shine. Now, cover your water. We'll go to part two. Cover it and protect it. Make sure nobody steals your water. Make sure. Sit down. Sit down. Sit down. Father, I give you praise. Listen. Listen. If you are here and you just buried your child, your child has died. Come to me. Your child has died. Come to me. You are here, your child has died. Come to me. If you are here, your child is not your husband, your child, like your child. Your child is dead. No. Because the Lord took me here. Come. Because the Lord took me here and the Lord said, Daniel, there's somebody here. When was that?
2015. He was Maryland's 325th homicide.
So is the death was like, ask her for me. I don't know what she's saying. Ask her for me whether the death was a killing death. Killing.
Yes.
It was killing.
Yes.
Follow me. No, sorry. It was here. Here. The angel showed me here. I'm sorry. The angel didn't come there. The angel came here. I need to be sensitive. Come. So the child was, is it killing? You know, the kind of killing.
Yes.
Is it the kind of killing that police came inside?
Yes.
That police came in. And they were investigating.
Yes.
And her to understand that are the police still investigating or they have closed the case? Because spiritually, the Lord said to me that there is not a close up on the case. The case is not a close up. Ask her for me.
Yes.
Is the case pending now?
Yes. Still
follow
open.
Me. Clap your hands to the name of the Lord. Because in the spiritual realm, the Lord took me there. The Lord said, Daniel, there's a lady sitting there that the child is killed. And the case is not closed. And the case is still pending. And the Lord said to me that the reason why the Lord showed me to pray for her is two things. Number one, the people that committed that atrocity, they are still lingering around. You know. Because always when you are moving about, you feel that some people are following you. Oh. And the Lord says, if you don't pray for her, they think, because the Lord says the case is not closed. So the people think this woman will testify against them. So now, let them follow her, and they will not just kill her, but they will just let another car hit her, so that it will happen as if it's not them, but it is the same people. But the Lord says, Daniel, because she's at Empowerment Temple today, go and expose those people and go, oh my God, my God, my God, my God, my God, my God, Jesus. Lift up your right hand. Lift up your right hand. Get me more envelopes on the altar as well. Lift up your right hand. Mommy, don't cry. That's why you are living in fear. You are living in panic. That's what is happening. This woman is in fear. She's in panic. The Lord said to me that they are following. There are four people. Two black guys and two Hispanic guys. Sit down. Sit down. Let's have to sit down. Sit down. Sit down. Dr. Jamal, that's what the Lord is saying to me. So this woman, you have been living in perpetual fear. Because the police cannot comprehend what actually happened. It was an issue about money. That's how it happened. And they thought their guy has taken their money. That's why they killed him. Ah! Shout Jesus. Shout Jesus. Listen, is there anybody here who is ready to sit on the chair today? I said, is there anybody here who is ready to sit in their new chair of destiny today? I don't want you to miss it. When I call for the chair, run to it. My God. My God. By Empowerment Temple, mommy, look at me. The Lord is saying to me, they are going to be arrested tonight. I said, they are going to be arrested tonight. One angel has entered into a house number. One house number is number 8729. And one of them, their house number is 1190. One of their house number is 3320. The Lord says angels are fighting for you. Oh, oh, hallelujah. 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 Someone shout fire.
Fire!
Shout fire!
Fire!
Shout fire!
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 Lift her for me. 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 Give me some of the envelopes. You will be part of the people that will sit on the chair, okay? When I call for the chair, make sure you come. Just give me. Jesus. Can you get my face towels for me? Get them for me, my face towel. Get them for me fast. Mommy, mommy, look at me. Mommy, the Lord said to me that recently they were going to try to put you on antidepressants. Antidepressants. They were putting you on antidepressants. The Lord says he has canceled the depression from you. The Lord said it has been canceled from you. The Lord said it has been canceled from you. Ah, listen. Dr. Jamal, the Lord is saying to me that as I'm speaking right now, the issue that is going on, because of the fear, she was going to seek for protection. I see police protection you're going to seek for. The Lord says, you don't need police protection anymore because the angels have taken over. Oh! My God, my God, my God, my God, my God. Jesus. Lady, come. Come and let me pray for you. Come. Young lady, come. Come. Somebody stand behind her. Let the answers always follow me. My ministration is crazy, so you need to follow me. Lift up your two hands. Now. Go. Now. I break it now. Hey. I set you free. I set you free. I set you free. Fire. Bring it to me. An angel just brought you a diamond shoe. The Lord says you are about to enter into the next level of your life. You are in the next level and the next phase of your life. Bring her for me. Bring her for me. Bring her for me. Come right now. Come. Come. Where's your mother? Where's your mother? Come, 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 come right now. Follow her. Bring her to me. The Lord opened my eyes and the Lord said to me that we should use this lady as a point of contact for your mother. Because something happened and I'm out to tell you, come. Come right now. Jesus. My God, sit down, sit down, sit down, sit down, sit down, sit down, sit down. Listen to me. Africans, right? African prophets, when you are prophesying, what happens is that, I'm sorry for the, that's how you prophesy. When the spirit is moving, there's no order. There's chaos in the atmosphere. That's how we do it. You want to lift up your two hands. You have a powerful destiny.
Hallelujah.
Powerful destiny.
Yes,
powerful Jesus. Destiny.
Oh, hallelujah.
But I saw a lot of ladies. And all the ladies, I saw a pot. And in the pot, I saw a lot of rings. And the Lord says, the destiny, the marriage, and the future of all the ladies in her family, the enemy has put them in a pot and has covered it. And the pot that is there, there is a bed that makes sure nobody comes close to it. So you, anytime you are going anywhere, a bed is always following you. Wherever you go, you see a bird, a pigeon, different birds that always fly around you. The Lord says that is the bird that has been chasing after you. But when I came close to you, the bird just fell down. Oh, somebody, you can do it better for God. You can do it better for God. Clap your hands, clap your hands. Sister, you will not fail anymore. You will not fail anymore. You will not stop what you have started. In the name of Jesus. The Lord says anything she starts, she's not able to complete it. Because of that bed. But today, the bed has fallen down. Oh! Somebody rejoice with her. Rejoice with her. I said rejoice with her. I said rejoice with her. Hallelujah! Now, the Lord took me to this lady. And the Lord said, Daniel, pray for this lady. Because this lady, something happened in her mother's life that nobody knew. And I saw them putting a woman on the ground, in the ground, that they are burying a woman. But when they were burying the woman, in the spiritual realm, they didn't only bury a woman. But all the future and the destiny of this lady's family was buried with the woman. So I asked her, where is your mother? And you say, where is your mother? She's dead. When did she die? 5 years ago. The Lord says, when the mother was dying and they buried the woman, mother, they didn't only bury her. They buried the destiny of their family. In order for you to believe what I'm saying, that's why since your mother died, nothing has ever worked well again in your family. Sister, don't cry. Don't cry. I didn't come here to make you sad. But I came to here to expose the devil. Since your mother died, check the family. Nothing has ever moved again. Everything is down, including you. Since your mother died, you have lost all your money. You have lost all your money. When your mother was being buried, they didn't bury her alone. They buried her with the destiny of the family. The night before your mother died, she didn't tell anybody. She got a dream, and a black dog came to bite her. That's how your mother died in the dream. Nobody knew, but that's how she died. The way your mother died, the black dog was not just a dog. It was a man in your family. The man was an uncle who was evil against your mother. Who was behind it? Hey! Someone say hallelujah. My brother, give me your right hand. I deliver you from wrong people who come around your life like friends. Anybody that will come around your life like a friend, but their intention is bad, I command the angels to expose them right now. Now. Right now. I expose them from your life in the name of Jesus. Somebody shout, expose. Shout, expose. My God. Sister, be on your feet for me. Yes, be on your feet for me. Come. Ask her for me, who is called Stevenson. Who is that? That's your last name. Who is called Atia? Come. Spiritually, the Lord is saying to me that you are going to be favored. Everybody watch her very well. Listen to me. This city is called Baltimore, right? And the state is called Maryland. Sorry, the state is Maryland. Sorry, you know I'm from Africa, so you have to understand, okay? Listen, I see that you are going to be honored. I see you doing a kind of non-profit.
Yes, sir.
And the non-profit is going to be very great. Ask her for me whether she likes non-profit, she has tried, or whatever is happening about non-profit.
A non-profit for women that are sex trafficked and young girls.
That's what you do.
Yes,
sir. You have it already. Oh. Because I saw this lady having a non-profit about abused girls. And the Lord says, you are going to be honored by the United Nations. Hey! Hey! Somebody shout fire, fire, fire! Because I saw a call was coming and they were calling you. I see you organizing events like fashion shows. You organize fashion shows? You just started a clothing line. Oh. And I saw that out of the proceeds and everything, you are giving it out. And the Lord said to me, you have been through hell before. Sister, your life, the Lord says, get ready for the book you want to write. The Lord says 3 days ago, he said to you, write a book. And it's something you are working on. You have been through hell. And when you went to hell, you came back. But the reason why, listen to me, the reason why the Lord brought you back from your troubles, so that your life will be an example to people. My sister, let me tell you something. Let me tell you. You are going to be honored and favored. As I'm talking to you right now, I've seen a housing association in this particular state. And I saw, is there any place that is called Hartford? Hartford in this area.
Hartford County, that's
right. Hartford. You live in Hartford County?
Yes, sir.
Jesus, prophesy.
Because I saw myself in a place that is called Hartford. And the Lord says, even where you live, they are going to call you to sit on a board. To sit on a board. You sit on a board.
Yes, sir.
Oh.
Jesus.
And the Lord says, not only that, but you are going to be so honored and you are going to be very busy. You are going to be so busy. The Lord says, don't stop helping the abused people. Because a day came in your life that you yourself, you almost became homeless. You was homeless. And the Lord said to me, all the things you went through was to prepare you for where you are going. You are going to, oh my God. Those who are clapping for her, it will come to you. I said, those who are clapping for her, it will happen to you. Shout Jesus!
Jesus!
Sit down. Get this envelope. When I call the people, you need to come and part of the people that will sit down. Because when you go to United Nations, they will even invite you to Washington for another award. The federal government will, sister, you'll be so great and the Lord will honor you. Just go. 25. Count 25 envelopes for me. Count 25 envelopes for me. Count 25 envelopes for me. I'm calling for 25 people right now. Oh, don't worry. Wait. Don't worry. I'm calling for 25 people. It's going to be fast. Count 25 and you count extra 15 on the side. My God. Somebody, let's bless God for the life of Pastor Jamel Bryan. A great man of God. Somebody, let's bless God for his life. You have a great, great pastor. Sit down. Empowerment Temple, listen. Now get me this oil. Empowerment Temple, listen to me. Empowerment Temple, the Lord said to me that he's now moving this church to the next phase of greatness. Dr. Jamal Bryant, the devil thought he was trying to fight you, but the Lord, I saw 7 angels of reinforcement that are surrounding you. The Lord says any attack designed against your life will never prevail. The Lord says they try to shut shut off your voice so that your voice will not be heard. But the Lord says his angels were with you. The Lord says your assignment is about to begin. All the years you have worked, the Lord says it was just the beginning. Today, the Lord says your assignment has officially begun. The world have not seen any great thing yet. They're about to see the manifestation. They tried to attack your health, but the angels preserved you. But the Lord says, when they tried you, they wanted to put something in your throat. But an angel took it away, and the angels preserved you. The Lord said to me, the spirits that have been chasing and ruling over the state of Maryland and in this Baltimore area, you are a threat to them. They have tried so many ways to shut down this building. But anytime they try, the angels come to open it. The Lord says, you are going to now enter into the next realm of the prophetic. The Lord says, your preaching will be prophetic. You will give prophetic utterances. Because I see you another level of also becoming an apostle. And I see many churches coming under you. And the Lord said to me that this is the official day that your next assignment has begun. Shh. Listen. Shh. Sit down. If you're a minister here, if you're a preacher here, like ministers for the church, you know, many ministers, deacon, blah, blah, you know, be on your feet. You know, ministers, elders, be on your feet like that. All of you, listen to me. You are not here to help the man. You are here to serve God. You are not here to support the man. But you are here to do the assignment God has given to you. All the ministers, the Lord gave me an assignment to pray for all of you. And I also give you some direction that you will do. All the ministers, okay? Something will happen. Now, before I call you to come and sit on the chair, the Lord told me that whilst I'm here, I should anoint all the exit doors of this church. That any power of the enemy that will try to come around, they shall fall be the name of Jesus. Oh, somebody clap your hands and pray right now. In the name of Jesus, we sanctify, we preserve. In the name of Jesus, we preserve. In the name of Jesus, may the Lord arise by the blood of Jesus. By the blood of Jesus, we command the angels of God to be positioned here every day in the name of Jesus, every minute, every hour. Angels of God, anybody that will walk here with an evil agenda, may God expose them in Jesus' name. May God expose them in Jesus' name. May God expose them in the name of Jesus. We anoint, we preserve, we deliver in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. My God. Sit down. The devil is in trouble. Yeah. I said, the devil is in trouble.
Yeah.
I said, the devil is in trouble.
Yeah.
All the ministers, lift up your hands and say, oh God, empower us now. Sit down. I'll call of you. Also, I told business owners to bring honey, right? You can. I'll pray for you as well. He said, be on your feet. Have you ever got twins in your family before? Have you ever got twins in your family before? You don't know anything about twins in your family. Come.
Twins. I'm twins. A twin.
You are a twin.
Yes.
Ah. Come. Because the Lord said to me that I should pray for some twins. That's why I asked you, are there some twins in your family?
Yes, I'm a twin.
You are a twin?
Yes.
Where's your twin sister?
She's in Chicago.
Chicago.
Yes.
Come and let me pray for you. I'm come to pray for your twin sister. She's a girl, right? A sister.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. S-O-N-Y-E. What's that?
Yes.
What's that?
That's her name.
That's her name?
Yes.
Okay. T-O-N-Y-E. What's that?
That's mine.
Shh. before you guys were born, has somebody ever told you before that many years ago trains appeared before? You didn't know anything about it, right? They never told you?
No.
Good. Let me tell you something. Over 500 years ago, twins used to be born plenty in your family. But after 100 years from that time, which is the past 400 years, it stopped. The reason why it stopped was because an uncle, an old uncle, was in your family. He was into occult. He was an evil man. Okay. He used the blood of innocent children to make wealth. So when he did that, it brought a curse in your family. So since then, there has been a lot of attacks and troubles and marital problems in your family. So the Lord said to me, oh my God. So the Lord said to me, God waited for some new twins to be born. So that the new twins that will be born will break that curse. So if you are a twin, then you came in that family to break a curse. As I'm speaking right now, the Lord is saying to me that not only that, but because that curse came to attack marital problems and bring marital problems in the family, God will use you to bring people back into good marriage. So the Lord says he will cause you to train people for good marriage. That's why the enemy fought you on that side. But God was there for you so that your life will be an example. As I'm speaking right now, the Lord is saying to me that a man was born in your family. What I'm saying is like the man is no more. He's no more. I see a name. J-A-M-E-S. James. Your grandfather. Yes. He's dead. Is he dead? Yes. A man was born in the family. The name was called James. Let me tell you something. This man I'm seeing, the Lord said to me that he used to help a lot of poor people. He used to help many people. And it was the man's goodness. That's why your family is existing today. Oh my God, my God, my God, my God. Fire, receive fire. Fire right now. Jesus. Everybody lift up your two hands. Shout Jesus. Now come. Buy the 25 envelopes. 25. Give me the 15 envelopes. Now everybody stretch out your hands towards me. Say in Jesus' name. I will sit in my chair. Of my new life. I will sit in my chair. Of my new destiny. Now everybody open your eyes. Listen to me. Shh. Listen. You're about to walk to me. You're about to run to me to take this envelope from my hand. You're about to sit on this chair. Listen to me. I fast every day of my life. Every day. People who know me will tell you. I pray 4 hours every day. When I was praying the whole day, the Lord said to Daniel, today, I want to move my people to a new place. The Lord said, Daniel, enough of the days and the times where they have been attacked by evil midwives. The Lord says, as they give their seed and their offering tonight, every evil midwife that has contaminated them, what was taken away, they are going to get it back. 25 people, I want you to be on your feet right now. I want 25 people that you know that you will be part of this, be on your feet. I'm about to take it from my hand right now. The Lord says, I should let you come right now. 25 people. The Lord says, let 25 people walk to me right now. You're about to take a seed. Listen to me. This is the seed. I want you to stretch wherever you are. If you don't even have it, make sure you have it right now. 25 people. Because the Lord said 25 and the next 15. With a seed. Somebody listen to me. 25 people with the seed of the $800. Get it from my hand right now. Be very quick before it finishes. Be very quick before it finishes. Be very quick. Fritz Roy, give me more. Be very quick. Fritz Roy. Let's be very quick. With the seed of the $800. Everybody, be very quick right now. Be very, very quick. Go there and write the check and take your credit card. God bless you. God bless you. Ah, sister, come. Where do you come from?
Guyana originally.
You come from Guyana originally. When you are bringing it back, I will tell you something, okay? Get it right now. Get it right now. Get it right now. Get it right now. Those people are about to sit on the chair. Who again? I told you to bring an apple. I'll put on it for you. Don't worry at all. There are 5 people. Listen, if you're taking the envelope, write your check. Go to the, swipe machine, right? Go there right now. Credit card machine. Go there right now. Help them. go there right now. Everybody. That five people who are still sitting down, the Lord says you are part of those people. Let me tell you something. I was preaching at New York, in New York, at Bishop Jordan's church. And I was calling for a seed. One woman was bringing her seed. And I said to her, because of your seed, God has delivered your daughter. And your daughter was pregnant. And when she was going to give birth, she was going to die. But because of your seed, God has delivered your daughter. I asked the woman, how many children do you have? She said, one. I said, is it a girl? She said, yes. I said, is your daughter pregnant? She said, no. So all of a sudden, everybody in the church, like, wow, Prophet Daniel, maybe you didn't hear it right. My God. And I said to her, no, your daughter is pregnant. I said, go outside and call your daughter. She went outside. She called the daughter. Sophia, Prophet Daniel says, you are pregnant. Sophia told the mom, mommy, I'm sorry, I'm not pregnant. So she came back to the service. Bishop Jordan was there. So everybody's like, ah, Prophet Daniel, we know you're a prophet. When anything you say, I said to them, God says, your daughter is pregnant. Let her go to checkup tomorrow and let her bring the results. The girl went for checkup. She came the next day. She was pregnant for 6 months. She didn't know she was pregnant. And I told them that the seed they gave is what is going to preserve her, because the doctors will try to cut her. If the doctors cut her, she will die. So 9 months comes, she goes to the labor ward. When she went to the labor ward, the doctor said the only way the baby will come out is for them to cut her. Then the ladies called Bishop Jordan in New York and said, Bishop, Prophet Daniel said if they cut my daughter, she will die. But the doctor said the only way the baby can come out is for them to cut the baby, and for them to cut the woman. So they were now arguing with the doctor. Doctor says, let's cut you. The woman says, no, don't cut my daughter, because the prophet says. So it was the word of the prophet against the word of the doctor. And how many people know that the word of the prophet for the word of God is bigger and better than the word of the doctor? Listen, whilst they were arguing, all of a sudden, the baby came out without a cut. Listen, this lady was there. Ask this woman. She was there in the service. It was a tension service. And now the baby has come and the lady's free. She came to testify. I said, the way you made me suffer for this prophecy, you need to give me extra $5,000. Now, write your check. If you took the envelope, write the check. Go by the credit card. If you're ready, come and sit down right now. Those who had the envelope, come and sit down right now. Let's be very quick. We have a lot of stuff to do. Get it right now, mommy. Get it. Get it right now. Get it right now. Come and sit down. Come and sit down. Sit down. Wherever you are, sit down right now. If you have the envelope, write the check, put it down. Sit down right now. Sit down right now. You are originally from Guyana. I'll come to pray for you. For the Lord told me that I should enter into your background. You are not from Guyana. You are from Ghana. You are not from Guyana. You are from... They always say that you are from Ghana. Because I've seen your great-great-grandfather that was taken by the slave trade. And when they were taken by the slave trade, they didn't go straight to Guyana. They were living in Florida before they took them to Guyana of the Caribbeans. Your great-great-grandfather, the name was called Mr. Emmanuel Akwesi Owusu. God bless you. Wherever you are, run to me right now. If you have the envelope, run to me right now. Run to me right now. If you have the envelope, if you took the envelope, run right now. Be very, very quick. If you have the envelope, run right now. Run right now. Run right now. Let me continue to prophesy and pray. This lady, your face looks familiar. Do I know you? From where? Very good. Uh-huh. Because it's like I've prayed for you before. From New York, right? Yes. Perfect. God bless you. Sit down. Be very quick. Yeah. You know, I'm very, very, you know, my eye is very fast in the spirit. Be very quick. A seed of $800. Wherever you are, let's be very quick. Let's be very quick. How many remaining? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Wherever you are, be very quick. If you took my envelope, run right now. Run right now. Let's be very quick. Write your check. Put it inside. Everybody will sit on this chair today. Everybody. Let's be very quick. And now listen to me. The Lord said, Daniel, when they come, the only thing I need to do is to stand behind their back and hold their shoulders. So let's be very quick so that I do it in unison. Let's be very quick. The man standing there, come. Do you know that God wants you to own banks, you. God wants you to own banks and financial institutions. There's a great destiny, you. You are a millionaire that God has created, and I need to bring it out. I see banking institutions, and I see financial institutions, and I see you even advising people about bankruptcy and how to make money. You, go and sit down. You need to do some. Go. Who is called Kevin? Who is called Kevin?
Me.
That's your name. Who is called Kathleen?
My wife.
Sit down. Sit down. Listen to me. Listen. You are not going to do 800. You are going to do 5,000. Can you do it? Yes. Can you do it?
Yes.
Do it now. Wow. Dr. Jamal is here, a member of this church. The Lord says he's a great man. There are some people, let me tell you something, there are some people who can single-handedly purchase a church building. The Lord says you are part of those people he has created. God will make you see wealth. Wealth. Because I see you advising people about wealth. And that's your destiny. From your infancy, all your life, you just want to do everything well. That is your destiny from your infancy. That's why you had a lot of hard time growing up. God prepared you for this day. Get a seat. Listen to me. Many people are sitting down. The Lord says, come right now. Wherever you are, run to me right now. Run. You are part. What? Come. Get it. Go. Run. Add more chests. Run. Be very quick. If you know you came to take the envelope, run. Your seed of the $800. You need to do more. Do what you can now and what you can later, but do it now. I will pray for business owners. You know, how many remaining? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Where are my 5 people? Where are you? Run. Get it. Run. My next 4 people, where are you? Get it. Be very quick. Run. No, sorry, this one is like my mother. She shouldn't run. Africa, you need to respect old women. Old women, if they bless you, more life. If old woman curse you, you are dead. So, mommy, don't run. Go to the... mommy, come and help her. Don't even go there. Use your credit card. Come and help her, mommy. Come and help her. Get it. Credit card people, come and help them. There are 10 people sitting down. You need to run to me now. Run, wherever you are, run to me. Because I want to prophesy more. I want to do a lot of things right now. Run to me right now. Thank you, young man. Come. Yeah, get it and you put it inside. Swiping people, help them. Yes. Chair, extra chair. Ushers. Who are the ushers? Help us.
Ushers, bring out some extra right chair, now. Please.
Get it
extra
right
chairs.
Now. Yes. Help them. Help them. Or you want to use the credit card for them? Yes. Run right now. Yeah, help them. Now let me do it for you. Jesus. Come and hold it for me. There are 8 people sitting down. The Lord says you are part. Okay, wait. I just saw something. I'll see it very soon. Sit down. Credit card. New life. Everybody, listen to me. The bottle of water you have, there are some things you need to do at home that I need to tell you, okay? So don't leave until I tell you the direction. Everybody, God bless you. Now, if you are sitting down, be on your feet. Be on your feet. And say after me, on the control. Everybody, make sure you have the seed. If you come and do it without the seed inside, I won't lie to you. I won't lie to you. You'll get nothing. I'm telling you. Oh, yeah. Yeah, I'm telling you. So if you know you are lying, you shouldn't be part. Listen, be on your feet. Be on your feet. Now, just say after me. Not you, only them. All of you, listen to me. Say after me. Say right now.
Right now.
I go back.
To the womb of my mother.
And I take back my destiny.
Back. Now.
Now sit down. Now be on your feet again. Say
right now.
I move back to the womb of my mother and I take back whatever was taken away. Sit down. Now be on your feet. Say any evil midwife that was sent against me, die by fire. Sit down. God bless you. Give it to me. God bless you. God bless you. No, the envelope. The envelope. God bless you. Then go and sit down. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. Make sure they have served you. Walk to me right now. 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 I'll pray for the business owners, so don't worry at all. I'll pray for the ministers. You know, do you know something? Empowerment Temple, today I'm giving all my all to you. Do you know the reason? Because this is my last service in the United States of America. I've been here for the past 14 days. I've preached for about 21 times. And I'm leaving tomorrow for London. So this is my last service. So I'm pouring everything.
18 okay. Services in 21 days.
Talk to. Yes, sure, no problem. No problem. But, you know, it's called, in Africa, I call it cash and carry. Don't come and take the blessing and say you don't have it. Go. Receive it right now. Where's the offering bowl? Father, I give a praise.
Father, offering baskets. Offering baskets.
Shh. Now give me the envelopes. Now the Lord says the next 40 people you are sitting down right now, the Lord says what you say you can is your seed of the $200. Walk to me right now. Come and take it from my hand. A seed of the $200. Walk to me right now. Walk to me right now. God bless you. Yeah, it's there. Put it inside there. It's there. Thank you. Get it right now. Walk to me right now. Walk to me right now. Yeah, a seed of the $200. There are some people that came to take the $800. They didn't come. I see you. So just take the $200 and come right now. Right now. Right now. Right now. Sister, can you, the $200, can you do another $200 for your twin?
Yes, I can.
Come, do it.
Okay.
Listen, why didn't you do $800? Why?
Why?
Do you know something? Because I see wealth coming to you.
Yes.
I see you designing and selling clothes.
That's what I do.
That's what you do.
Yes.
Go and sew and enter into your boutique.
Okay.
God wants to give you a building. And you are sitting down. I see a boutique. I see a boutique. Go and do 800. I see a boutique for you. A boutique. You'll be a preacher. You'll be a boutique woman. You'll be everything. And I see you teaching, counseling girls about marriage and single people. You. That's your destiny. And you are sitting down. Come on, come. Go and do it. Get it. Walk to me right now. Walk to me right now. Walk to me right now. Everybody, go to the credit card. Ah, young girl, come. May God cover you. Any spirit that wanted to bring diabetes to you at a tender age, I cancel it. It will not survive. God bless you. Be very quick. God bless you. God bless you. Thank you. Did the 5,000. God bless you. Everybody, watch out for this man. I said, everybody, watch out for this man. Watch out for this man. You said $200 here. Now, if you have the envelope, go and sit down. When you take the envelope, don't go back. You go and sit down, okay? There are many things I need to do. There are about 5 things I need to do, okay? Let's be very quick. $200, everybody. $200, everybody. Walk to me right now. Walk to me right now. Just sit down. Write your check. Use the machine, whatever. Do it right now. If you have the envelope, just walk to me right now. Nobody should leave until I give you the instruction for the water. Look at the face of a neighbor and say, my neighbor, don't leave without the water. Don't leave without the instruction for the water. Wow, let's be very quick. Let's be very quick. United Nations woman. You are blessed, though. You are so blessed. You are so blessed. Walk to me right now. 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 A seed of the $200. Everybody, walk to me right now. Walk to me right now. Mommy, may God preserve all young people around you and your family. In Jesus' name. I declare, may you receive good news. good news is close to you. May you receive it.
My God.
May you receive it in Jesus' name. God bless you. May God elevate you. May you sit on your chair, on your seat of elevation. I see people celebrating you. People are celebrating you. You'll be celebrated. You control people. You control people. Sit down. God bless you. Walk to me right now. Walk to me right now. Walk to me right now. Now let me do it for them. Let me do it for them right now. Whilst I'm doing it for them, I want everybody to come to him and take now, everybody, your seat of the $100. Everybody. Take it. Come and take it right now. Everybody needs to sit on this chair. Everybody. Right now. Now, so when you have it, get it. So all of you go to him and take it right now. Right now. Right now. Right now. We will do the water direction. Then we will do the honey. And so many things. Don't worry. Okay. This is my last service. I'm giving my all. Okay. I'm giving my all. In the name of Jesus. New life. New life. When you have it, just come right now. Come right now. New life. New life. New life. Be very, very quick. New life. Be very, very quick. New life. New life. New life. New life. Sister, you are wearing African dress. Are you from Africa? You are from Ghana? Oh, wow. Yeah, because this one is for my country. Amen. Like what I'm wearing is only for my country. If you see anybody else wearing some, tell them they stole it from my country. Amen. Amen. God bless you, Chanel. God bless you. This lady was Ghana. She came for a conference in Ghana. God bless you. The best nation in the world is America and Ghana. Amen. 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 It used to be America, but after last year, it's now Ghana. Amen. God bless you. Ah, I see a big sword in the hand of this man. But the Lord says, I've left United States of America. And when I left United States of America, we are flew to another nation. The nation I flew into is called the nation of Haiti. The Lord says you should go to Haiti because there is a hidden blessing, centuries, that needs to come to you. Ask him for me whether he knows Haiti.
Yeah, I know Haiti.
When was the last time you went there?
A year and a half ago.
Why did you go there?
My son was playing for the Haitian national team.
Do you have any connection from Haiti?
Yes.
What connection is that?
My father's.
Your father is from Haiti?
Yeah.
There's a long, long, long lost blessing there. As you came, it has been released unto you. God is going to cause you to shine in Jesus' name. Walk to me right now, everybody. Walk to me right now. Walk to me. Walk to me right now. Walk to me right now. A seed of the $100, everybody. Everybody, make sure you sit on the chair some, okay? Make sure. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. Prophetess, God bless you for coming. You see me after church, okay? God bless you. God bless you. Talk to me right now. Wow, you two, you came, Providence. God bless you. God bless you for coming. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. Receive the grace. New life. New life. New life. New life. New life. New life. May God cover you. Anybody that cursed you behind your back, may God expose them. May God expose them. In Jesus' name. New life. New life. New life, new life, new life. Do you want one? God bless you. New life, new life, new life, new life in Jesus' name. Let's be very quick. Everybody just sit down. Let's be very quick. If you have the envelope, just come. Don't worry. Don't worry. More space. More space for you. Don't worry. Even if the space finishes, we'll get you more chairs. Don't worry at all. Don't worry at all. Don't worry at all. Everybody put your hand by your ears right now. And say, no more bad news.
No more bad news.
Say, I broke my ears.
From bad news.
Listen to me. If you watch the movie that is called Get Out, that you know that it's not everything you need to hear. When the guy put the cotton here, that's when he was saved. I declare, may the angel burst out from your ears. In the name of Jesus. Jesus' name. Now all of you, be on your feet. If you are here, just be very quick before. Be on your feet. Be on your feet. Say after me. Say right now. Every evil midwife, leave me alone. Now sit down. Sit down. Yeah, sit down. Be on your feet again. Say every evil midwife, leave my life alone. Sit down. Be on your feet again. See, I walk back into my destiny. Amen. God bless you. Give me the envelope. Yeah, be very quick over there. Go there very quick. William Shakespeare said, be to thy own self, be what? That's right. Be very, God bless you. Young lady, you have a bright future. What do you do? What do you do?
School and work.
Why are you reading? Why are you reading in school?
Just science books and math.
Don't joke with it, okay? You go very far. You go so far.
I will. Okay? Thank you. I appreciate
God bless
that.
You. Thank you. I pray that no evil man will come around you to disturb you. Okay? Let's be very quick. If you have the envelope, run to me right now. Walk to me right now. God bless you. God bless you. Put it inside there. God bless United Nations. God bless you. You get a lot of awards. Go. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. Now, everybody sitting down, everybody sitting down, come right now and take your seat of the $50. Everybody. Everybody sitting down, down. Everybody, the seat of the $50. Everybody, and rush and come and sit down right now. Everybody, come right now. A seat of the $50 right now and come and sit down. Everybody. Yeah. Can I get a, you know, you stand on this side and help them so that I help these people. Okay. Yeah. Put it inside. God bless you. God bless you. Yeah. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. Now, a seat of the $50. God bless you. God bless you. Your mom is free. God bless you. Everybody, a seat of the $50. Come and sit down. Everybody, come and sit down. Everybody, come and sit down. Come and sit down right now. A seat of the $50. Everybody. God bless you. What do you do? I see control. You control people. What do you do? For the federal government. You control people.
Yeah.
I see you control people. You are the executive officer. Because I see you control a lot of people.
Yeah.
May you be promoted more.
Oh.
In Jesus' name. You go to church here?
Yes.
Secure your seat very well. Never leave this church.
Okay.
Because the Lord says you have an assignment in this church. The day you leave this church, you lose your position. Don't lose this church.
Oh, I'm going to stay at this church.
Perfect. Sit down. A seat of the $50, everybody. Now listen to me. I think I'm struggling with the envelope. So if you have the $50, let's forget about the envelope and just come and sit down like that. I think it's okay, right? Yeah. Just sit down. Just sit down. Just sit down. If you are here, just sit down. Very, very quick. Just sit down. Just sit down. A seat of the $50. Everybody. 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 I'm speaking like an American. Everybody. Everybody. Everybody, God bless you. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying?
Thank you.
You know what I'm saying? You know, there are some places when I go to preach over there, when I speak my accent, they don't understand. So I've started learning American language, you know. You know, I read civil engineering, did my master's in construction management, also working in my business administration in PhD. But still, when I speak American accent, they still don't understand. So I have to learn their ways. You know what I'm saying? Everybody now. You know what I'm saying? You know? Yeah, you know? You know? Yeah, you know what I'm saying? You know? Yeah. Yeah. Am I doing well?
Yeah.
Perfect. You know what I'm saying? 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 Yeah. Good. If you are there, just come right now. Instead of the $50, sit down. Sit down. Instead of the $50, come and sit down right now. Now, all of you. God bless you. God bless you, my brother. God bless you. He's from Ghana. He was in my meeting in Ghana. God bless you. Young man, you are wearing African dress. Where do you come from? Nigeria. That's why you are wearing. But this one is not from Nigeria. It's from Ghana. Why are you learning from us? God bless you. Are you a member of this church?
No.
Who brought you?
My uncle.
Where's your uncle? Are you a member? Are you a member? So you brought him. He's going to be very, very successful. He will deal into real estate. Write it down. Do you know real estate?
All right.
That's all you will do. Okay? I push you into it.
Amen.
New life. New life. New life. New life. In the next 5 minutes, then we do the water direction. New life. New life. New life. New life. Anybody that cursed your mother that wanted it to affect the offsprings, I've canceled it today in Jesus' name.
Amen.
New life. 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 New life, new life, new life, new life, new life, new life, new life. Now all of you be on your feet and declare after me. Say, Lord Jesus, every evil midwife, leave me alone. I will live long. I will enjoy my destiny. Sit down. in Jesus' name. A young man, you're the one I prophesied to you on Sunday, because my team told me that you sent a message on Instagram. So sorry, is it Twitter? So they got back to me and said, I prophesied to you on Sunday about business, and also that's what you're working on and writing a book. And this young man said when he received the prophecy when he was leaving the church, a church member met him and said, because of the word, I'm sowing a seed capital into your business. Empowerment Temple people, you are so good. Is the person here, the person who did that? Is the person here? Wow, the person, Empowerment Temple people are very good. My brother, so I came to confirm. Now, the boy is in your court. Go and become successful and bring your tithe to the man of God. God bless you. God bless you. Get it from my hand. God bless you. Yeah. God bless you. Go and sit down. God bless you. God bless you. Yeah. Yeah, I'm just taking the envelopes. Amen. Amen. God bless you. Let's be very quick. Walk to me. Come. Walk to me. We're about to do the water direction right now. God bless. Let's be very quick. Let's be very quick. God bless you. My friend standing there, he's from Ghana. We went to the same grade one together, up to university. He's my best friend. God bless you. No problem. God bless you. Thank you. Thank you. We can put it there. God bless you. God bless you. Is that your mom is free, okay? If you're a member of Empowerment Temple, every Sunday, 7 a.m., make sure, 7:30, make sure you are here. 9:30, make sure you are here. 11:30, make sure you are here. Tuesdays, make sure you are here. Empowerment Temple, listen to me. The Lord has taken the church to the next phase. Make sure you are part of the move.
We missed on our blessing.
Oh, you missed on your blessing. I'm sorry. Get your blessing back. Hey! I love church members. She wants to take it back. Receive, sorry,
it's okay.
New life.
Now be on your feet and let me do for you quick.
Yes, good. New life.
Thank you, sir.
Be on your feet. Say, evil midwife,
evil.
Leave me alone.
Leave me alone.
I take back my destiny.
I
am blessed.
I am
blessed. Sit down. Amen. Now, everybody sitting down, don't worry at all. I'll do for you. You're my friend. Don't worry at all. No, you can go. God bless you. I will do for you later. Now, everybody, your seed of the $20 or the $10, everybody, come and take it right now. Everybody, if you're not sat down, everybody, you have not sat down. If you are not sat down right now, mommy, may God bless you in Jesus' name. Are you a member of this church?
Yes.
What do you do here?
Security.
Security. Mm-hmm. So when people are coming, you are the one, you fight them back,
yes,
for us.
Yes, yes.
Wow, are you very strong like that? Yes. That's very good. Yes. Mommy, the Lord says of all the things you have lost, He's going to restore you.
Thank
you. The Lord says you are in a season of restoration and God will restore you great time.
Yes.
In Jesus' name.
Yes.
Get ready for your elevation,
yes,
and your restoration.
Thank you.
In Jesus' name. There have been a lot of battles and challenges. The Lord says it's not been easy,
yes,
but the Lord says you have always put your trust in Him. And because you put your trust in Him, the Lord says He will never disappoint you,
yes,
in Jesus' name.
Yes.
The Lord says as you are still serving in the church, He's bringing you long life. The enemy wanted to take you away 5 years ago,
yes,
and God kept you.
Yes.
You are free in Jesus' name. God bless you. God bless you. Yes, sit down. When you have it, you sit down. More envelopes, more envelopes. God bless you. God bless you. Yeah, take it. God bless you. Now, everybody, let's do this and let's do the water direction. Everybody, let's do this. I'll give you 3 directions for the water. You never wait for me. I'm coming. Okay. Give it to the man. Let the man put it inside. God bless you. Everybody, a seed of the 20 or 10. If there is a child by you, let them do some. Everybody. You know, when you take the envelope, don't go back. Just do it straight out. Sit down. Sit down. Please, let's sit down very fast and let me do for you the next batch. God bless you. God bless you. When I shout Empowerment Temple, then you declare, I recover all. Empowerment Temple,
recover all.
I recover all. Empowerment Temple,
I recover all.
Empowerment Temple. Envelope, envelope. God bless you. God bless you. Everybody. Right now, Empowerment Temple is my family. Oh, you didn't say me, which means you don't like me. Take it, put it inside. Thank you, young girl. May God bless you. God bless you. Yeah, sit down. Sit down over here, okay? Don't worry. Now, everybody, okay, let me do this thing for you. You know, if you are coming, just come and take it so that when I finish the next batch, I do the next batch, okay? Let me do it quick. Young girl, may God bless you in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Some wrong people are leaving you. Wrong friends, they are leaving you, okay? New life, 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 in Jesus' name. New life, new life, New life in Jesus' name. I break heart attack from you. New life, 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 new life. Receive new life, receive new life, receive new life, receive new life in Jesus' name. Be on your feet and declare after me. Say, Lord Jesus, every evil midwife fighting my life, die by fire. Sit down. God bless you. Now take it from my, let me take it. God bless you, auntie. God. Auntie, what's your name?
Mara.
You are free in Jesus' name.
Thank you.
God bless you. Very, very quick. Oh my God. Oh, you're not going there. Don't worry. Be very quick there. Very quick there. God bless you. You're not going to swipe the car. So you get a blessing first before you swipe the car. These people are very smart, you know. They are so smart. They get a blessing first. But when you go to the supermarket, you pay first before you eat. God bless you. Go and swipe. God bless you. All swipers, go and swipe. Now, everybody, God bless you. Everybody, make sure you sit on the chair with your seat, okay? $20, $10, whatever. God bless you. Now, sit down. Next batch, sit down. Next batch, sit down. God bless you. Ah, come. Come. May God order your steps. You not be caught up in any gun battle. Jesus. You not be caught up in any gun battle. Jesus. I set you free.
Hallelujah.
Go. Thank you. God bless you. You are a blessed woman. Walk to me, everybody. I'm praying for you.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I know.
Oh, okay.
Listen, it's like they want to make him mad. That's what they are doing. He's a great man, but they want to destroy him. Break! 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 You not go mad. I deliver you. You not get any stroke. Go. Everybody, be very quick. Everybody. If you are not sat on the chair. Yeah, yeah. No problem. God bless you. I prayed for him. Okay? Get it. God bless you. Where are you from? Wow. You are a blessed girl. New life, new life, new life, new life, new life, new life in Jesus' name. New life in Jesus' name. New life in Jesus' name. Get it and put it in there. New life. Have I touched you? Have I touched you? Have I touched you?
No.
Okay, have I touched you? Okay. New life, new life, new life, new life. New life, new life, new life, new life, new life. New life, new life. I deliver you. I send angels at where you live and where you stay. There'll be no problem and no issue there. New life, new life, new life, new life, new life, new life, new life in Jesus' name. New life in the name of Jesus. New life in Jesus' name. Be on your feet and say after me. Say, be on your feet and say after me. Say, any evil midwife, leave me alone. I get back my destiny in Jesus' name. Sit down. Amen. God bless you. Take it from my hand. God bless you. Thank you. God bless you. Walk to me right now. God bless you. 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 How many people believe they have recovered all? God bless you. 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 May God remember your life. May God favor you all in Jesus' name. God bless you. God bless you. Now, everybody, you be on your feet and get your water. I hope everybody have sat on the chair, right? No? Just come and sit on it. But what are you waiting for? Be very quick. You know, I want to do the water direction. My time is even fast spent. May God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. If you're not sat on the chair, come and sit on the chair and let's do the water direction and let's go. God bless you. If you're not sat on it, take your seat and sit on it. Cover you. Preserve you for good. I preserve you for good. Who brought Mama to church? Who brought her?
I did.
Who is she to you?
My friend.
She's your friend. God deliver her from every spirit of death in Jesus' name. God bless you. Now everybody sit down. If you're not sat on the chair, come and sit on the chair. Take any seat at all and come and sit on it. Sister, I see you writing all the prophecies. Are you an intercessor? Is she an intercessor? No, her. Are you a member of the church?
Yeah.
Is she a member of the church?
Yeah.
Is she a member of the church? Because I see her writing all the prophecies. Is it her assignment? It's not an assignment. Then the ministers need to speak to her because she's writing everybody's prophecy. Maybe when we finish, she's going to give to them. If not, then it's not required. Amen. So the ministers and the security work on that. Amen. 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 Everybody. Just sit down. Everybody. Because sometimes people want to write prophecy to keep it. But if it's not for that and she's not being instructed, then it's wrong. Are you a minister here? So let the ministers confront her very quick. Very quick. Amen. Amen. Sit down. Sit down. Sit down. You've already sat down. No problem. Everybody. Everybody. Now, Madam Security. Good. Follow her. That's your job. God bless you. Now, everybody be on your feet. Sorry, just here. Now, let me tap your foot. Let me tap your back. Let me tap you here. Receive the power of God right now. New life, 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 new life. Now be on your feet. Say after me. Say in the name of Jesus. Every attack against me from my mother's womb, I destroy it in Jesus' name. Sit down. You are blessed. Amen. Now go. Everybody clap your hands and take your bottle of water. Clap your hands and take your bottle of water. Everybody, clap your hands and take your bottle of water. God bless you. God bless you. Take your bottle of water and be on your feet. And let me give the instruction. Clap your hands and take the bottle of water. God bless you. Clap your hands and take the bottle of water. God bless you. Clap your hands and take the bottle of water. God bless you. Take it. God bless you. Let's be very quick. God bless you. 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 Now take your bottle of water. God bless you. Hope everybody have sat down right. Oh, God bless you. Yeah, you came to my church in London, right?
Yes, yes.
God bless you. And you say you live in Maryland. Anytime I come to Maryland, you come to my service and you have come. Bless you. God bless you. Make sure you become a member of Empowerment Temple, okay? God bless you. They came to my church in London, you know? Wow, you did very well. Now, everybody, take your bottle of water. Prophet Roy, where's my water? Where's my water? Me too. I need more blessing, you understand? I will not tell you to do directions and I will not do some. I need to also be anointed. Amen. Let's be very quick. Now, everybody, listen to me. Mama, did you sit down already? Oh, good, good, good. Now hold it for me. Now everybody follow me on the control. Sorry about your carpet. Sorry about your carpet. Wash your hands. Your hands will hold wealth. Your hands will hold money. Whatever has been stopping your hands from receiving money, we are washing it away right now. We are washing it away right now. Debts are canceled. Debts are canceled. You will not lose your job. You will not lose your salary. You will be an entrepreneur. You start your own business. Your business will not collapse. The monies your family members have not been able to receive, God will cause you to be the first person to receive it. You own mansions. You hold new keys. In the name of Jesus. Now this is the last direction and I'll tell you what we do at home. This is the last direction. This is the last direction. Every human being is a seed. Put water on you. At the smell of water on a seed, it grows. Everybody, you shall flourish. You will grow long. And you will live long. God will bless you. In the name of Jesus. The dryness is over. The famine is over. I said the famine is over. You will flourish. You will nourish. God will bless your life as never before. Shout, I receive it. Now. Now close your water. Close your water. And now sit down and listen to this instruction. Now I want all the ministers of the church to see me right now. All the ministers, come right now. The Lord told me to pray for the ministers. Walk to me right now. Walk to me right now. All the ministers, walk to me right now. Come. Come very close. Very, very quick. The driver that picked us from the station, the place, may God bless him.
Michael.
And the one who also came to pick me, God bless you. And the assistant that we've been working with, where is she? Minnie or something, where is she? May God also bless her in Jesus and all the people that are supporting. All of you come. May God empower you all. I'm holding your hands and may God preserve you all in Jesus' name. You are the first person I prophesied to write. Follow the prophecy in everything. You are a blessed man and just don't disconnect yourself, okay? Great things are happening. You are free in Jesus' name. I empower you in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Now, all of you, listen to me. The Lord told me to just hold your hands to pray with you so that the church is going to next level now. The Lord said the next level, you are going to be more active. So the Lord said you need to be more united. You are going to be more active. And because a lot of assignments, you're going to have a lot of assignments. A lot of assignments, seriously, because I see the church climbing in another elevation. And that's where you are going. And the Lord says, all of you, I should let you do something. That's what the Lord said to me. The Lord said, do you know something about Psalm 91? He who dwells in the secret place of the Most High, will abide at the shadow of the Almighty. The Lord said to me that I should let all the ministers take a seed of $91. And for you, you go and place it at the top side of the altar. As you go and place it there, when you are going, you will climb and go. When you go, you're telling God, God, as the church is climbing up, I'm climbing with the church. Where's the dollar? Give it to them. A seed of $91, okay? $91, all of you. That's what the Lord instructed me to give to you, okay? And go and do it right now. And when you are going there, climb up. When you are going there, climb up the altar and do it. That's what the Lord said to me. Yeah. Can you give me some of the envelope? Amen. You can go there right now. Either cash or check or you use the machine. Amen. God bless you. Have you gone to work with her? I saw you working with her, right? Good. You know, as a prophet, when I'm ministering, my eye is everywhere. And my eye is everywhere. When I'm ministering, I see everything. I see everything. I see who is who. I see who is who. I see who came for an assignment or whatever. I'm telling you for real, for real. Amen. Now you can go. Take it and when you take it, climb up on the last part where the podium is. And you place it there and you declare, I'm growing and moving with the church to the next level. All of you, go and do it right now. Go and do it right now. Go and do it right now. Just be very quick. Now all the entrepreneurs of the honey, be on your feet for me. All the entrepreneurs of the honey, be on your feet. God bless you. Yeah, 91. Everybody, just be quick. Wow. Sister, God bless you. You are the one I prayed for you on Sunday, right?
Yes,
God bless you. How are you?
Good.
Business will work well, okay? Don't worry. God reveals to redeem. When the Lord shows me anything, it means it has been canceled. Get more strong. Be confident, okay? You are going to do much. You are going to be so great. All the honey, the entrepreneurs, come to me right now. Let me show you what to do with the honey. Now, everybody, listen to me. The water, when you go home, at the entrance of your house, pour it there for the next 3 days. Tonight, tomorrow, and the third day. On the third day. And when you pour it there, this is what you say. No more bad news in this house. May good news enter. If you are living somewhere you don't like, pour it there and tell God, God, I want to move away. And God will surprise you. At the entrance of your house, at the entrance of your house, bad news is leaving, good news is coming. And if you want to move, God will let you move. Okay? So keep the water very well for the next day. You pour it there. And on the third day, after 12 noon, on the third day after 12 noon, which is today is the first night, Wednesday, Thursday. So on Thursday after 12 noon, then you drink the remaining and you declare new strength for my new level.
Amen.
New strength for my new level of recovery. Come close to me. Come close to me. Yeah. And all of you, lift up the honey. Everybody, listen to me. The next time I will be here, we will do a honey direction. I will let you know that honey is made by a bee, but the bee who makes the honey can even kill a person. So a bee that can kill can give you something sweet. So it means as you eat the honey, anything that destroyed other people, when it comes to you, it will be sweet to you. Lift it up. Say, by the power of God,
I consecrate
my honey.
My honey.
Now all of you listen to me. Entrepreneurs, listen to me. Let me stand here because I'm short. You can't see me well. Listen to me. This is what you do. You take the honey and put it in water and drink it for the next 21 days. As you drink it in the morning, you declare, God, let my business be sweet. Let me tell you something again. Do you know something? It's a honeybee that makes the honey. But let me tell you something. I've never seen a honeybee eating honey before. A bee makes the honey, but the bee never eats the honey. The bee struggles to make the honey, but somebody comes to enjoy it. It means as you eat this honey, what you didn't work for will come to you. God will give you sweatless victory. God will give you effortless victory. I said the honey bee makes the honey, but the bee never eats it. It's the farmer and you that enjoys it. You are going to enjoy the honey. Did you make the honey yourself? It is a bee somewhere. Maybe right now the bee is already dead, but you are the one enjoying. Your business, things you didn't struggle for, it will come to you. Now all of you look at me. The Lord said to me, I should give you envelopes and you are going to swipe right now. You are going to sow a seed into your business and everybody, a seed of the $100. Take it from my hand and go and do it right now. All entrepreneurs, go and do it right now. That's your seed capital for your business. Go there right now. Write your check and do it. Is that what you do? What's your business?
I have a day spa for girls.
A day spa?
Yes.
Wonderful. Yeah. Mommy, what do you do? What do you do? Mommy, what do you do? Yeah, what do you do? Yeah.
I'm
sure. Wow. God is going to bless you. That's what the Lord told me that because you need to do this direction. The next time I will come, I will do a honey service. Oh, let's be very quick. Give it to them. Be very quick right now. Give it to them fast. Take it from my hand. Yeah, fast. Everybody go there right now. A seed of your $100. God bless you. God bless you. Give it to her. Give it to her. Everybody. Oh. Everybody go and sow your seed in it right now. God bless you. Empowerment Temple, you are blessed. Now all of you just go and sow it right now. The last thing before I call pastor to come, I've gone over my time, but I know that I'm giving my all. Amen. Now the last thing, listen to me. Everybody listen to me. How many people have been blessed because I came? Are you sure? Are you sure? Now listen. Listen. Are you sure? Let me tell you something. As a prophet, listen to me. This year, every year, I made over 100 flights. I travel everywhere in the world. It takes money to fly. It takes money to sleep in a hotel. When I came, Pastor Jamel has put me in the Marriott in downtown. Powerful place. It's so amazing. And I'm not alone with my assistant in another room. Listen to me. It will be very, very unfair if the cost goes on Pastor. You are the ones who came to be blessed more. I'm calling for some people who are saying, Prophet Daniel, we want to offset the cost of your hotel. We want to offset the cost of your hotel. And I want just 10 people who are saying, Prophet Daniel, I want to give a seed of $200. Just 10 people or more that will give either $200 or $100. If you know you are part, just come. I want to know whether you love me. The more you come, will show me that I will come here again. If you don't give, it means you don't want me to come here anymore. Now I want to see your heart. I want to see your heart. Let me see. Walk to me right now. A seed of $100, $200, or a $50. Walk to me right now. Thank you very much, my sister. Thank you. You want me to come again? Thank you. God bless you. Go there right now and swipe and do it right now. Thank you for helping me to come again. Thank you. Listen to me. I want everybody to come. 10 people. I have about 5 people remaining. Come right now. Mommy, thank you very much. Thank you very much. Walk to me right now. Walk to me right now. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Let's offset every cost of the conference. Let's assort it. Yeah, I told somebody to bring olive oil and also apple. Come to me right now. Olive oil and apple, come to me right now. Who again? Who again right now? Walk to me. You're saying, Prophet Daniel, I want to offset and help the cost. Walk to me right now. You came to be blessed. You are just sitting down looking at me. You know, you don't want me to come again, right? You don't come again? Amen. Come and take it from my hand. $50, $100. Whatever, come and take it from my hand. Whatever, come and take it from my hand. Let's offset the cost. Let's offset the cost. Let's offset it right now. God bless you. Okay, you are helping them. Yeah, God bless you. Come and put it down. God bless. When you come, you give it to this wonderful man. God bless you. By this apple, I declare, I consecrate it. Why did I tell you to bring the apple?
You said that I had 5 boys.
Okay. As you eat it, let there be a miracle. Tomorrow, 2 p.m., you eat it. On Saturday, 7 p.m., eat the next one. This is the one you eat on Saturday. Let me mark it for you. This one is for Saturday. Get it. And this one is for tomorrow. 2 p.m. and Saturday, 7 p.m. Go. This is what we call prophetic instructions. Go. God bless you. Which oil? Which olive oil? Did I tell somebody to do olive oil? Anybody to bring olive oil? I think it's done. Now lift up. Thank you very much. God bless you. If you have any seed, come and place it down. Any seed at all, place it down. Any seed at all. God bless you. Come and place it down. God bless you. Thank you. Thank you. Place your seed down, everybody. Is that what you do in this church? Come. What do you do here? What do you do here? You're just a member.
I'm in the choir.
So you just forgot yourself. I said, what do you do here? So you're just a member. You sing.
Yes, I do.
Don't stop singing. Don't stop singing. Okay? Because as you sing, God is bringing long life to your family. Long life is coming to your family. And God is also canceling any sickness from your family. Then you wanted to bring cancer to your family, but because you will sink, it will be canceled. Don't stop singing. Sure, fitness woman, I prophesied to, right? Let God arise. Listen, you go to the place I call the address. Then you sprinkle the olive oil there on tomorrow. And you tell God that there will be no casualty over here. And everything shall be well. And God will bless you. After that, every day, anoint yourself, your forehead and your feet. And God will bless your life. Now say after me. Oh, is it olive oil? May the blood of Jesus take over right now in Jesus' name. You always put this olive oil in your head like this. And you, it's not your forehead. You put it here at the apex of your head here. And you declare, God, let my cup run over. Do it for 40 days. You are blessed. What did I tell you to do? I told you to bring olive oil. Father, I thank you. Always take the oil and anoint your back. And say, may God deliver you from pain. You're going through some back pains. God has delivered you. God bless you.
Thank you.
God bless you. Lift up your right hand. Lift up your right hand. See after me. Now, we are going African way. Anything I say, you say amen. Anything I say, a thunderous amen. That's what we do in Africa. May you recover all.
Amen.
May you recover all.
Amen.
May God order your steps.
Amen.
You will not die before your time.
Amen.
Anybody waiting for your downfall, they shall fall before you. Anybody that will take your name to any negative place to attack you, may God scatter them right now.
Amen.
Anybody that will take your photo or your image or your picture to an occultic place to attack you, may the fire of God fall down.
Amen.
You will not lose money anymore.
Amen.
Wealth will locate you.
Amen.
In this season of recovery, may you recover all.
Amen.
You will never lose your loved ones. You are blessed.
Amen.
May God bless Empowerment Temple.
Amen.
May God bless our pastor, Dr. Jamal Bryant.
Amen.
May God bless all the members of Empowerment Temple.
Amen.
May our heavens be open in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Shout amen for 3 times.
Amen.
Now we are shouting Jesus for 7 times. 1.
Jesus.
2.
Jesus.
3.
Jesus.
4.
Jesus.
5. 6,
Jesus.
7.
Jesus.
Now the last thing, listen to me. I'm about to count 3. I'll count 1, 2, 3. The first person that will jump on their feet to shout, you'll be the first person to leave here with a miracle. Wait. I'll count 1, 2, 3. And the person, wait. I will, but not now. Listen to the instruction. I'll count 1, I'll count 2, I'll count 3. When I get to the third one, the one that will, sister, sit down. You are already rigging the elections. You are already rigging the election. You are already rigging the election. Don't be connected to the Russians. Why are you connected to the Russians? You're already rigging. She's already been a Russian person. You are not from Russia. You are from America. Don't do that. I will count 1, 2, and the third one, you scream and you shout. And this is the shout. I recover all. So I will say 1, 2, 3. Amen. All my guests that came to see me, you meet me at the hospitalities. You talk to the protocols about that, okay? All my guests. So I will say 1, 2, 3, then you scream. The first person that will scream, I'll recover all. You are living here. You are being the first person to live here with a miracle. 1, 2, 3. Sit down. 1, 2, 3. Sit down. Now the person that will jump tall, you will go tall. 1, 2, 3. Let's clap once and invite Dr. Jamal Bryan to bless us. God bless you.
God bless you. Thank you. Welcome home. Thank you. Bless you. Would you stand right where you are, Brother Ernest? If you'll stand, every person is standing. Shatika Musser, here she comes. Thank you so much. I need somebody's hand in your hand, please. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory. We can't dare leave out of this place without somebody having an opportunity to get saved. Somebody finding Jesus for the pardoning of their sins. Would you take one moment, all heads are bowed, all eyes are closed. Would you pray for a soul to get saved tonight? Pray for somebody to find Jesus Christ tonight. Would you pray even right now for somebody to make Empowerment Temple their home tonight? Pray that God will use you to bring them closer to Him. Praise Him in advance. I want you right where you are, if you'll lift up your heads. I want you right where you are. That neighbor's hand is still in your hand. Hear me very carefully. If you're not sure you're saved, I want you to squeeze that neighbor's hand twice. If you don't have a church home that exercises in signs and wonders, squeeze that neighbor's hand twice. If you feel like you are in a place where you are no longer growing in God, and you need a fresh start in a new place, would you squeeze that neighbor's hand twice? Just because you're in church doesn't mean you're in Christ. I can't remind you enough that when you get to heaven, they'll never ask you who your pastor is. They only want to know who your Savior is. You're here today and you do not know Jesus Christ after being under this kind of authentic anointing. Please don't offend the Holy Spirit by walking out the same way you came. Leave with a greater level of conviction. I yield. What must I do to be saved? I need you to follow this, please. If you'll loose that neighbor's hand, here's what I want you to do. I want you to give God glory in advance for what He's going to do. I say, give God glory in advance for what He's going to do. Here's what I need, please. If your neighbor squeezed your hand twice for any of the aforementioned questions, would you please bring them to one of these seats quickly? If in fact they squeezed your hand twice, whether it was about having a church home, about being saved, about giving their life over to God, I need you to bring them to the altar now. Come on, here comes one. Are you going to give God glory? Here comes two. Are you going to give Him praise? Here comes three. Are you going to give Him honor? Hallelujah. You're not sure whether they were squeezing your hand or trying to get rid of your hand. I want you to do this for me. Let's just be sure we're sure. Would you talk to the person on your left, on your right? Ask them, are you sure you're saved? Are you sure you got a church home? Are you sure you've given your life over to God? Hallelujah. Bless that wonderful name of Jesus. For these three who have come on this Tuesday night, give God an overwhelming applause of affirmation. Bless His name. Everybody is standing. I need you in an overwhelming way. Would you help me thank God for Prophet Daniel? You can do better than that. How many of y'all want him to come back? If you want him to come back, make some noise right there. Bless the Lord.